Yes, the director. He asked me to come do audio commentary, and now he's telling me to shut the fuck up so you can hear the story and so on and so on. So I tell you what, I'll be a liberal democrat for a moment and make a compromise, no? I shut the fuck up now, but then when there are no talking characters, I will be a Stalinist and with Iron Fist annoy you with all the crazy Lacanian bullshit.
I have never been close enough to someone to tell them what I wish to tell you. If you were to know who I am before we meet, I'm sure you would think this is an elaborate joke. That is why I insist that whoever you turn out to be, we meet in person in order for me to convey to you the details of my confession and the job I'm offering you. I realize these vagaries are not very attractive, so allow me to add that the compensation for the completion of your duties will be extremely generous. If you can appreciate that, despite all appearances, a successful man can be consumed by an insatiable need, a hunger which can only be quenched in ways that mainstream society finds hard to digest, then perhaps we can understand each other.
Here, I think, is a very clever example of ideology. So, as we find out later in the film, the man who posted this ad to fulfill his shameful desires and so on and so on is this wealthy, young, attractive entrepreneur or some, you know, postmodern software company or whatever. The point is, it is only through his, how do you call it, model involvement in mainstream society that he can realize these elaborate fantasies which supposedly go against the mainstream of society. And of course, the way he is able to realize these fantasies is by hiring this down and out guy, working class, by using the very material offered him by social class to go against society. Also, from the poor man's perspective, he views this opportunity for a large payment and so on and so on as a way to escape his role as a slave in the system. But this, I claim, is the nature of ideology today. Is that through this very act of attempting to escape from the system that one in fact perpetuates it. We can imagine that if the poor man were to win his money, he would use it similar to fulfill his dreams and so on and so on. And how does the money allow him to do this? By exploiting the working class. Well, my God, this is the story of global capitalism.
Please come in. I'm so very glad that you emailed me. I hope you brought your appetite. Oh, I just have to run to the kitchen. I think something's boiling over.
Moça do corpo dourado do sol de Ipanema, o seu balançado é mais que poema. É a coisa mais linda que eu já vi passar.
Would you like a glass of scotch?
Yeah. Sure.
That's what I thought you'd say. It's dreams.
Cheers.
So let's get down to business. I bet you're just bursting with questions.
Well,
my name is Abdullah Cornelius von Schlibbenbach.
I'm Dave. Wait a minute. The Abdullah Cornelius von Schlibbenbach, CEO of Vortex Software Company?
Indeed. And I bet you're wondering what my all-consuming secret is, aren't you? I'll tell you what. Right after I take off the pumpkin pie.
Ooh, there's pumpkin pie?
I want to be eaten alive.
What? I know. It's not something most people understand. I don't really understand it myself. All I know is that ever since I ate my first gingerbread man at the age of 3, it's become a dark obsession of mine. These worldly things, power, wealth, they do nothing to satisfy the primordial yearnings of the soul. There's only one thing that can. I need to become the gingerbread. That's where you come in.
No. You can do what you want on your time, buddy. But I'm not gonna be a part of it. Not for any amount of money.
Please, gnaw at my bones. Absorb me via osmosis. Let my proteins be divided by divine providence.
No, dude.
Your endoplasmic reticulum.
Come on.
Please. Please.
Oh, snap out of it.
I'm sorry.
I should have never forced my desires upon another. I just need to continue this suffering until I find my prince.
So I'm gonna head out.
No, please. I know it's a lot to ask, but I really do appreciate you listening. You're the only person who knows this about me. May I, as a thank you, have you for dinner? Normal dinner, I mean. And pumpkin pie?
No, I don't think so.
I already did cook up quite a bit for side dishes. They can be hors d'oeuvres.
No. I'm okay.
Pumpkin pie!
What the hell?
Great! BRB!
Pumpkin pie. Pie, obviously, is the vagina, and to pumpkin is to fuck your mother, no? Here, I love this bit! I just shut the fuck up again so you can enjoy it. No, I lied, so I can enjoy it. Fuck you!
And I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Oh!
Okay, that does look pretty good, I have to admit.
Bon appetit.
Are you gonna have some? What?
You just ate my dick.
What?
You just ate my dick.
You know that ain't my dick!
Love hurts. Love scars. Love wounds. And Mars. Anyone. Not tough. Nor strong.
I'm coming.
I'm coming.
Oh, I'm coming.
My dick is hot.
Love hurts. Love hurts. I'm young.
You know, I've said before elsewhere that the reason San Francisco exists is so Hitchcock could film Vertigo there. And I think something similar of this film. I think Craigslist exists so that this vulgar obscenity could be made about. If there is some order or purpose and so on in the universe, this is how it functions, I claim.
Vertigo.